during the archetype, what is the important crops during the Jayad season? So during the Jayad season, the important crops is cucumber and muskmelon, and another vegetables also, some food crops also, fodder crops also is there. And next we are going for the major crops. What we are discussing till now, in India, types of the farming, how many types of the farming is existed in India, and later we discussed about the cropping seasons. Next we are going for the major crops. In India, food crops and non-food crops are growing. So presently we are going for the discussing about the important food crops in India. So in India, food crops and non-food crops and commercial crops are growing. So presently we are discussing about the important food crops, which one is the growing in India. So now we are discussing about the food crops, important food crops in India. Okay, children, now we are discussing about the food crops. So among the food crops, paddy, wheat, maize, millets and pulses, these are all the important food crops. Which one is the we are using as the our food items, that crops we can count as the food crops. So first one we are going for the paddy. One by one we are discussing about the we can count as the food crops. Paddy, wheat, maize, millets, pulses. These are all we can count as this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These 5 crops we can count as a important food crops in India, which one is growing in our Indian from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from every state. So one by one we can now discuss paddy. Paddy is the, this crop is important staple food of the population of the country, which means in India most of the people, almost are 60 to 70% of the people are eating to the this rice. That's why we can call it as a staple food. If you take the food habits of the country people, most of the South Indian states people are eating of the this rice, but some of the North Indian people are taking their diet condition wheat. They are making of the wheat, they are making of the rotis from the wheat flour. So little bit is different from South Indian people and North Indian people. North Indian people are eating of the more rotis and South Indian people are eating of the more rice. This is the slight different. Now we are discussing about this paddy. So this what we are producing of this paddy, what we are producing of this paddy total food grains is, India is the second largest country in the world after the China, which means our paddy production levels is the very much we are producing. After the China, we are the second position in the world. China is the largest country produced by the paddy production. So after the China, now we are able to be producing of the second position in the production of the food grain production, paddy production in the world. In the world, after the China, now Indian country is able to producing of the largest producer of the paddy after the China. Our position is second position. So now we are in the world, our second place, second largest country in the world, India. And its requirement of the minimum 100 millimeters of the rainfall is required. How many centimeters here? 100 centimeters, not 100 centimeters of the rainfall is required. 100 centimeters minimum for the production of the paddy. 100 centimeters of the rainfall is required, and 25 degrees of the temperature as required for the ripening of the that food, that crop. More temperature as required, more rainfall also required for the producing of the paddy. one side is the temperature is more required, another side is the rainfall also more required. Almost it is the paddy is kharif crop. During the kharif season in India, paddy is producing more. Why? Because during the kharif season, India is getting to the 80% of the rainfall. That is the southwestern monsoons, which one is the entering to the in India from June. Southwestern monsoons has received given to the more rainfall in India. That's why 80. That's why this paddy has kharif crop, which means during the kharif season in India, most of the farmers has cultivated. That's why we are getting to the more food grain, more quantity of the paddy during the kharif season. This minimum requirement of the 100 centimeters of the rainfall is required, 25 degrees centigrade of the temperature is required. During the kharif season, it has cultivated more and more land. And also here, important production of the paddy, important area if you take in India, northern plains, coastal area and deltic regions. Deltic regions. So these are the, if you do northern plains, Indo-Gangetic plain area. Northern plains is nothing but wherever the Indus rivers and the Ganga river is flowing, this area is the producing of the more paddy. That is the northern plains. And coastal areas. Coastal areas is nothing but which area is beside of the nearby the ocean, sea, that area we can call as a coastal areas. That is the West Bengal or Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu. These are all the important coastal areas. So these coastal areas, states also producing more and more quantity of the paddy. First, there are three areas is producing more paddy in India. That is the one area is the northern plains, second area is the coastal areas, and third one is the deltic area. Delta area means, delta means where the rivers are merging to the oceans or sea, that before the entering of the river into the sea, the river has divided into 2-3 parts. The 2-3 parts between area we can call as a delta area. If you take the any rivers, it is entering to the before going to have the India oceans, before the entering of the oceans into the rivers has divided into the 2-3 parts. So this dividing area is this shaded area is that is a deltic area. Deltic. So this delta area, which is called is this delta area is very very more producing of the paddy. And this is the regarding to the paddy crop. And second one is wheat. Second crop is wheat. So wheat is also important crop in India. This is the paddy is the kharif crop, wheat is rabi crop. You can identify difference between the paddy and wheat. Paddy is the important kharif crop, wheat is the important rabi crop. So this wheat is requiring to the 50 to 75 centimeters of the rainfall is required. And during the sowing period, this wheat crop is required to the cool climatic conditions. During the harvesting period, this wheat is required to the more temperature. Ripening of the crop, it is required, that's why more temperature. During the sowing period, wheat crop is required to the cool climatic conditions. During the harvesting period, this wheat is required to the more temperature. This is a different comparing to the paddy and wheat. So here, important producing wheat zones in India, three zones has mainly produced by the wheat crop. If you take the Ganga Sutlej plain is the one area and Black Soil area of the Deccan area. So these two zones here, one is Ganga Ganga Satluj. Ganga Satluj area. And second one is black soil area in Dakhan. So in India there are two zones are producing of the more wheat. If you take the that area is Ganga Satluj area, that is the North India, and black soil area in Dakhan plateau, which means this is the South India. These important two zones are producing of the wheat. So if you take the important producing states, if you take the this wheat, especially major states produced by the this wheat crop, Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan, and parts of Madhya Pradesh. These are the important, mostly if you take the produced states, if you take observe it, most of the states has belongs to the North India. That's why North Indian people are eating more chapatis and rotis compared to South Indian people. South Indian people are prepared to the rice, North Indian people are prepared to the rotis, because of they are producing of the more and more wheat. That's why they are their staple food is North Indian people staple food is wheat, but South Indian people staple food is paddy. So this is the difference between South Indian and North Indian. So wheat is producing of the North Indian states are more producing. And next one is the third crop is maize. So maize also very very important in the country. This maize is which is the here third crop is maize. So this maize crop is in India, it is the food crop as well as to the fodder crop. Fodder crop, which means fodder to the fodder means that is the food to the animals. So which one is eaten by the animals, that things we can call as a fodder. So in India, this maize is food crop as well as to the fodder crop. So if you take this maize, it is also maize also it is required to be 21 degrees to be 27 degrees of the temperature as required. 21 degrees to 27 degrees of the temperature as required. And also in India this HYV in this maize crop cultivation, here HYV seeds are utilizing. Here this maize crops in India, HYV seeds are using. HYV seeds means high yielding varieties are using. Already we are discussing the starting of the lesson. So high HYV, along with the HYV seeds, water facilities, that means irrigation facilities, mechanization, fertilizers and pesticides we are using. That's why those who are cultivation by this maize crop, these farmers are getting more crop compared to the other crops. So that's why this maize crops also in India we can it is using of the feeding to the many animals. That's why we can call it this is a fodder crop. So important producing states are maize producing states are Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. Important maize producing states are Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. These are the important states is produced by the maize crop. And next we are going for the millets. Millets means next crop is millets. Fourth one. These millets also we can call as a coarse grains, coarse cereals, what we call as coarse cereals. So this coarse cereals is nothing but which means small grains. Coarse cereals is nothing but that is the small grains. That is the jowar, bajra and ragi. Jowar, bajra and ragi, these are important food grains in the millets. So these millets in India, these millets has had very high nutritional values. This millets has high very high nutritional values, including calcium and micronutrient levels is very very rich in this in this millets. If you take the ragi malt, if you take the bajra and you take the jowar, these grains has having to the consist of the rich nutritional values. So here if you take the jowar, One by one, we have three things. Jobar is the third. Jobar is the third most important food crop in the country, which means in India, most of the population has a important food crop is rice. Second food crop is wheat, and third food crop is jowar. Important food crops in India mainly three crops. They are paddy, that is the rice, paddy, wheat, and jowar. So most of the population is eating the rice. We know that. And second food crop in India is wheat, and third crop is jowar. So this third food crop in India is jowar. So jowar is the also very rich in high nutrition values. Maharashtra is the larger producing state in the country. Maharashtra is the larger producing of the jowar. It is after Maharashtra, many states has producing, but mostly Maharashtra is producing of the more quantity of the jowar. And second one is bajra. This is also one coming of the millets. So bajra also, it is the producing of the Rajasthan is the producing of the more and more this bajra. So if you take the bajra, this is bajra grows well in sand soils and shallow black soils. Sand soils and black soils are very suitable for the growing of this bajra. So Rajasthan is the larger producing state in the country. Bajra has produced by the larger quantity Rajasthan. And the final third one is the ragi. So ragi is also very high nutritional, especially calcium, which one is very useful for the human body. So it will be given to the more strength of the human bones also. So this ragi is produced dryland areas, which means if it is not available of the irrigation facilities, this drylands is very suitable for the growing of the ragi crop. So this is also Karnataka state is producing of the more quantity. Ragi is produced by the more quantity by the Karnataka state. So if you take the jowar is produced by the Maharashtra more, bajra is produced by the more quantity in Rajasthan, and ragi is the Karnataka is produced by the more quantity. These are the important states, which one is the under coming of the millets. These are the important crops. And last one is we are discussing about the pulses. So pulses also, last one, pulses. So pulses means red gram, green gram, Bengal gram, sisma. These are all the sisma is oil. So important pulses in the red gram and green gram, Bengal gram. These are all the important pulses. So India is the highest producer of the larger producer of the country in the world. If you take the pulses, at the same time, India also largest consumer of the these pulses. Now, in the world, India is able to producing of the more and more quantity of the pulses, and at the same time, India is the utilization of the more pulses. So we are able to be producing of the more quantity of the pulses. At the same time, we are using of the more quantity of the consumption. So we are able to produce more quantity of the pulses, and we are eating more percentage of the pulses we are consuming. That is the our credibility. But what we are able to the producing of the pulses, that pulses are not enough for the our how much population is living in India. So this pulses, what we are producing, this pulses quantity is not enough for the Indian population. So that is the clear here. Main source of the this pulses, the main source of the protein food, those who are taking as a vegetarians in India. Main thing is these vegetarians, these pulses are very important for the their proteins. So here important what we are producing of the pulses crops in India. This pulses crops, which one is produced by the our India, this pulses crops as directly observed by the These pulses crops is having to the leguminous roots. So most of the which one we are producing with the pulses crops, these pulses crops is having to the one special feature, that is the these pulses crops is having to the leguminous type of the grass roots. This leguminous type of the grass roots has a directly captured by the nitrogen from the air. So this is the best thing. That's why it is more and more producing. And important producing pulses producing states are Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Karnataka. These are the important pulses producing states in the country. These are the important food crops what we are discussing. Okay, children. What we are discussing today class, this is the introduction class for the agriculture in India. So, in agriculture in India, agriculture is, what is the agriculture is nothing but most of the people are depending upon the farm activities, that is we can call it as a agriculture sector. So, completely it is depending upon the nature. So, before the independence, during the olden days, different types of the farming types is existed. Basically, farming are two types, subsistence farming and commercial farming, we are discussing. Subsistence farming is nothing but that agriculture has given to the only enough to the food grains to the their survival in. That which one is the food grains as produced by the subsistence farming, that food grains are enough for the their feeding, their minimum requirement. This type of the agriculture we can call as the subsistence farming. Subsistence farming is again two types, that is the simple subsistence farming and commercial subsistence simple subsistence farming, intensive subsistence farming. Simple subsistence farming, farmers are using of the traditional techniques only. This type of the agriculture we call the slash and burn method, which means the farmers are shifting to the agriculture one place to another place. There is no much more production. Intensive subsistence farming is nothing but farmers are using of the more labor units. They are using a little bit of the pesticides and fertilizers. Here also crop production is very less. When it comes to the commercial farming, during the commercial farming, farmers are using of the HYB seeds, high yielding varieties, mechanization using, and pesticides and fertilizers are modern techniques are using under the commercial farming. Commercial farming, farmers are getting to the more income, and under the subsistence farming, farmers are not getting to the any additional incomes. In India, based on the climatic conditions, cropping seasons are different. So in India, cropping seasons is three types: Rabi season, Kharif season, and Jayad season. Presently, which season is ongoing presently, this month is the December. This is the best example of the Rabi season.